the tradition begin. It's another night of Frontier Bobcats volleyball here live on AreaSports.net. We are at the Bobcat Den, otherwise known as the Mule Barn at Fairfield Community High School Gymnasium. Tonight, the Frontier Bobcats hosts the Morthland College team from West Frankfort. I'm Randy Olson here courtside, along with Chet Snyder. Chet, of course, is the head volleyball coach of the Fairfield Lady Mules, and they were victorious last night. A big win for them in high school volleyball against the Edwards County Lady Lions, and we'll talk to him about that here coming up in just a bit. What you're seeing on the floor right now is you're seeing some warm-ups out there, as the girls in green are from Morthland College, and they are doing some warm-ups right now, and the horn just blew, and now the Frontier Bobcats will come out and warm up a little bit as well, as we are about 14 minutes away from match time. And again, joining me as he did last week on the premiere of Bobcat Volleyball is Chet Snyder. And Chet, good to see you tonight. And let me first of all say congratulations on a huge high school volleyball win for you last night as your Lady Mules beat the Lady Lions of Edwards County.
Good evening, Randy. Thank you very much. Yeah, we had a fun night here at the Mule Barn last night. The place was packed out. You know, it's our annual pink game, and Edwards County always travels really well, and we had a great crowd, and we finally came out on top.
And that match went three games last night, and you won that third and final game 25-5, which raised a few eyebrows when they saw the scores. But your Lady Mules played really, really well, and that gives you a lot of confidence heading into the rest of your schedule.
Yeah, it does, because, you see 25-5 and you think we played really, really well, but when you go back and watch the video, we didn't play really, really well. We served the ball really well, but our ball control wasn't very good all night. And our girls know it, and we got to get better. But it was good to get that first win, let me tell you.
Oh, absolutely. And you bounce right back here tomorrow night. You'll be taking on Wayne City.
Yep, got Wayne City coming to town. Lamar took over, once again there. It's always fun to coach against Lamar, and he'll have them ready to roll.
All right. Well, tonight we're seeing the Frontier Community College Bobcats from here in Fairfield taking on the Morthland College team from West Frankfort. A couple of firsts tonight as well, because it's a first-year program for both of these schools, and both teams so far have played just one match, as Morthland College lost a five-set match to Lincoln Trail College, and, of course, Frontier in the broadcast that we had last Thursday night lost in three straight sets in their opening match against Southwestern Illinois College. So one of these volleyball programs, Chet, is going to win their first ever college volleyball match.
That's
pretty exciting.
Very exciting.
And I know Coach Jessica Hughes would love for it to be the Bobcats, and we had a chance to visit with her a little bit ago. We're going to play back that interview in just a little bit. But reflecting back on what we saw in the match last week, what do you think that the Bobcats need to do, what they need to work on and do better tonight in order to be successful against this Morthland team?
Ball control is the key for them. They've got some big guns. They really do. For a first-year program, they have several girls they can go to, and, I mean, they're terminators. But you have to have good ball control to do that. And so the passing's got to tighten up tonight, and if they do that, I think they're going to be tough to beat.
There are a few players on this Morthland squad that you might recognize, but they also have a number of out-of-state players as well, and we'll be going through their roster as we go along here. But let's play that interview that we had earlier this evening with Jessica Hughes. On the pregame show with Jessica Hughes, and Coach, you've had a chance to go back and watch the video now from your match the other night for the Bobcats. And after watching that, I'm sure, though, you have to still be very pleased with a lot of the positive things that you saw out of your players, huh?
Yes. Went back and watched the video actually several times. Had too many serves that were out on the negative side. Still a lot of nerves. You could see it. Just, watch them in practice for the last 2 months and then watch them in a game. The way they hit, was not the way they normally hit, and just, I'm afraid I'm going to hit it out. Or I'm afraid I'm going to hit it. And it's like, you can't play with fear. Just hit it and be done with it.
Well, now that they got that first match out of the way and hopefully the jitters out of the way, hopefully they can let it rip tonight against Morthland College.
Yeah, I was telling somebody today that, I was extremely soft. Yeah, it's okay. Tonight, no first game anything. We're going to, play like we practice.
Well, this is a team that you're playing tonight that is much like you. It's a first-year program, first-year volleyball program. They also also have just played one match the same way you have, so a lot of equals tonight.
Yeah, should be a lot of equals. Tony just said, you know, how many games have you played? I said, oh, just one, and he said, yeah. So, we'll be about the same. All learning experience. That's the first thing he said. It's not like high school, is it? I said, no, it's not. It's very much different.
Now you got some girls that double up and they play softball as well, and that might be a little bit of a factor for you.
Actually, the trainer texted me today, and she said, you've got a lot of sore shoulders and a lot of sore elbows. So, yeah, we're probably going to take a break one day this week. And softball, I mean, they've been playing doubleheaders, you know, every other weekend, and that's a lot, even on a young student.
Yeah. Well, best of luck tonight, Coach. Thanks for the visit.
Thank you.
That's Coach Jessica Hughes here of the Frontier Community College Bobcats prior to tonight's match against Morthland College. And Chet had to step away here for just a moment as he's visiting with one of the officials down there on a few things here in the gymnasium. And then we'll get some comments from Chet here in just a moment about Jessica's comments. But you heard her talk about a few things there. The fact that she went back and she's watched the video from our broadcast the other night a couple of different times and noticed, obviously, that a lot of the serves were long, were deep, and that certainly the nerves, the jitters, were all part of it the other night, and that, they've got to get over that. And, hopefully they'll be much more calm tonight as they've got a game under their belt. And, of course, these are veteran volleyball players who have played at the high school level, and so they've been into a lot of pressure situations before. They've played tournaments back in their high school days, so it's not like they're not used to playing in pressure situations. So hopefully they can come out and play a little bit more under control tonight and be a little bit more confident about hitting the ball and not, you know, worrying about hitting it out and that sort of thing, and be able to produce a win tonight against Morthland College. Again, we'll remind you that in college volleyball, you play the best of five sets, best of five games, instead of the best of three like you do in high school. The first four games will all go to 25, and if there is a need for a fifth and deciding game, it goes to 15, or whoever wins by two. So that's how you do it here at the collegiate level. Tonight's broadcast, by the way, is made possible by Fairfield Printing and Graphics. They have school gear and team gear for Fairfield, Wayne City, Jasper, Sisney, Jeff, New Hope, and others. They can produce and make T-shirts, sweatshirts, hoodies, letter jackets, as well as banners, signs, vinyl decals, and a variety of other things to show your school spirit or to promote your church or your business or other organization. Fairfield Printing and Graphics can be reached at 842-4048. And they're located just west of Fairfield on Route 15. Again, the number is 842-4048. That's Fairfield Printing and Graphics. Tonight's broadcast also made possible by the Sports Zone here in Fairfield. They're located on Delaware Street in Fairfield. They provide individualized instruction, one-on-one instruction, a variety of different sports. And something like the jump program that they have at the Sports Zone is something that can really benefit volleyball players, because jumping ability, vertical leap, vertical jump is so important in every sport, but very, very important here in volleyball. And so if you are someone who plays volleyball, or if you have a daughter or granddaughter who plays volleyball or aspires to play volleyball, you might talk to them about the jump program that they have at the Sports Zone in Fairfield. That's something that could be extremely beneficial to them. Tonight's broadcast is also made possible by Wainwright Propane. You know, it's just about winter heating season. May not feel like it today with the temperature in the 90s, but it's going to change here real quick, and we'll be running those furnaces here real soon. And the price of propane right now is at the lowest price it's been in over 10 years. So you might want to think about filling up that propane tank before the price goes up and before the demand goes up. Also, Labor Day is just around the corner. That means there's going to be a lot of Labor Day cookouts, and so you might need to refill that tank for your gas grill in time for those Labor Day cookouts. You can do that at Wainwright Propane in Fairfield. That's Wainwright Propane. Also, tonight's broadcast made possible by Jagger's Doggy Daycare in Mount Vernon. They offer dog grooming, dog obedience training classes, and doggy daycare for your dog, featuring separate playground areas for both large dogs and small dogs. And there's playground areas for both indoors and outdoors at Jagger's Doggy Daycare, located at 224 North 11th Street in Mount Vernon, right across from Central Christian Church. You can visit their website at jaggersdoggydaycare.com. Chet Snyder joins me back again right now. And Chet, want to ask you about your thoughts. There you go. Trying to get that together there. Ha ha. There we go. This way. There you go. Just going to ask you your thoughts on Jessica's comments tonight. You heard part of her comments before you went down there to visit with the official.
Yeah, some of that is dead on. You know, you just – kids cannot play scared. You can't play sports, you know, if you have any fear. And so I think, you know, they'll be more relaxed tonight.
I think that they will be too. There's not as much of the hoopla before the match tonight like there was last time with all the introductions of the softball team as well as the volleyball team. Crowd's a little bit smaller tonight, although it's still a good crowd that's starting to come in here to the gymnasium. And I feel like that they're going to come in tonight with some confidence, too, because they know they're going up against a team that, again, is on the same playing field, so to speak, as they are because it's a first-year program. And so they have to come in with some more confidence tonight, you would feel.
Yeah, I just talked to the official. He had Morthland's match, and he had Frontier's match. And he thinks Morthland's a little bit better defensively, but Frontier just has too much power for him, he thinks. He's picking Frontier, so.
All right.
I don't know if the officials are supposed to do that.
Well, you know, that was off the record, and we won't say which official anyway. So there you go. We got a couple different officials. But it's going to be an interesting matchup tonight here against with Frontier and Morthland going at it. Morthland, by the way, is from West Frankfort, and they play most of their matches at West Frankfort High School, although I was talking to one of Tony's assistants earlier, Tony Phelps' assistants, and said that sometimes they have to play at one of the junior highs there, too, depending upon the schedule at the high school, of course.
Yeah, he said they got stuck in the junior high gym the other day, and it was well over 100 degrees in the gym. He said he's too old for that.
And I think they have the same situation down at West Frankfort as we have here in the Mule Barn or the Bobcat Den, as we call it, and that is the heat because there is no air conditioning in this gymnasium, and there's no air conditioning down there in big old Max Morris Gymnasium at West Frankfort either. That's another hot box.
Hot box, but a wonderful gym.
Oh, it is.
Watch high school sports.
Oh, isn't it, though?
It's a really good gym. And
seats a ton of people.
Yep.
Yeah.
And here, I mean, I think we're kind of spoiled with air conditioning in Southern Illinois. You know, it used to not bother us near as much as it does now, I think. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I think you're right.
Or maybe I'm just older and fatter. I don't know.
Okay. Well, let's look a little bit at this roster for Morthland College and talk about some of these players and where they've come from. Brianna Holmes is from Creel Springs. Shayla Stone is from Marion. Rebecca Mosley is from McLeansboro. I'm sure you remember her.
Yes, I do.
Sandra Hartline from Cobden. Krista Irwin from Fishers, Indiana. Ellen Luther from Murray, Kentucky. Ruth Raby from Sparta. It's kind of interesting because there's a Sparta girl on the Bobcats roster as well, so I assume they were teammates in high school. Elizabeth Guerrero from St. Elmo. Victoria Lara from Laredo, Texas. She's a long way from home. And Olivia Woods from Cocoa, Florida. She's also a long way from home.
Yeah, that's a long way.
We want to welcome those parents and those viewers and those fans from Morthland College who are also watching our broadcast tonight. We understand that there are some of them logged on watching the live video stream tonight on AreaSports.net, and we're happy that we can bring the broadcast their way, particularly those who are out of state and obviously can't drive here.
Yeah, when your child's playing something, second college game of their life, you know, and they live in Kentucky or Texas or Florida, that's a great thing that, you know, you can provide for them.
So. Yeah, so hopefully they enjoy the broadcast tonight, and we may sound a little bit slighted towards the Bobcats. We apologize for that, but it's the hometown, and But we are not afraid to call a good play. If it's something very positive by Morthland, we will certainly not be afraid to say that. And so we look forward to the matchup tonight. Size-wise, well, it looks like that the height advantage is going to go to the Bobcats. You know, with Robbie Lake at 6'3", and Alana Renner at 6', and Lexi Pedke at 5'10", because really Morthland doesn't have anybody over 5'10". The Victoria Lara, the girl from Laredo, Texas, is 5'10", and then the girl from Cocoa, Florida, as well as the girl from Murray, Kentucky, both 5'9". So size-wise, across that front line, Frontier Bobcats a little taller, but that doesn't always mean everything, does it?
No. Tony's teams are known for defense. They're going to play – Morphin's going to play good defense. They're going to play really hard. They're going to be playing as a team. I talked to him last night. He came and watched our game against Edwards County. He's recruiting – trying to recruit, you know.
Sure.
And he was really concerned about the Bobcat size, you know. We're just a little bit bigger than them, and he said they really, you know, struggle with bigger teams at the net. So it'll be interesting to see how their tough defense handles the Bobcats' attack.
You have known Tony Phelps for a long, long time. He's been in the coaching ranks for a long time, so you guys go way back.
Yes, sir. He's definitely one of my mentors, just a guy who does it right. He's also, you know, in the ministry. He's a pastor of a small church down at Dahlgren, and he's doing a great work with these girls.
Mm-hmm. And we're showing him on camera right now as we get ready for, I think we're going to have the national anthem here in just a few moments, and then we'll be set for action. Again, we play best out of five at the collegiate level instead of best out of three like you do at the high school level. So you've got Wayne City tomorrow night, your Lady Mules do, and then after that, you're off until next week, and I think you are... You have Casey, don't you?
Yeah, Saturday we go to Casey. Yeah, Casey, okay. That'll be a tough tournament for us. Our JV is in it as well, and that I like that, but our varsity, we're going to win, you know. And mm-hmm. I use some players mm-hmm. sub, but so our bench is going to be a little short. But it'll be a good experience for our JV too. Our varsity pool is Sisney and Effingham St. Anthony and Newton. So it'll be a good match.
Well, and you play a lot of games in a short period of time up there at that Casey tournament, don't you?
Day.
Yeah, five games in that one day on Saturday at Casey. And we'll follow along here with the public address announcer as the players are lining up on the floor. They're going to lower the flag, and we'll have the playing of our national anthem. Our national anthem here tonight at the Bobcat Den, and if I'm not mistaken, that is the Whitney Houston version that was played in the Super Bowl, about 10 or 12 years ago, I think?
Yeah.
Been a while.
It's been, I think, about 20 years ago.
Maybe it could be. So. Time flies by.
During Desert Storm,
you know what? I think you're right. I think it was about 20 years ago. Yep, time definitely flies.
There's a bunch of people coming in.
There is, and that's a good sign. We welcome the fans here tonight. If you're in the Fairfield area, you still got time to get here.
Patriot fans, it looks like.
Mm-hmm. Yes, Morthland College is the Patriots. Some preliminary announcements being made here by the PA announcer, and then we'll meet the players for both squads. Morthland College Patriots wearing the green uniforms tonight. Number one is Brianna Holmes from Creel Springs. Sandra Hartline, number four from Cobden. Number seven is Krista Irwin from Fishers, Indiana. Alin Luther from Murray, Kentucky. She's number eight. Number 12 is Victoria Lara from Laredo, Texas. And number, was it 11 or was it number 18?
11,
okay.
We have two 10s there.
Yeah, they have two 10s there, that's right. One of them's got to be 11, okay. Alyssa Kolak and some of the Bobcats being introduced right now. Lexi Pedke, number 10, from Woodlawn. Number 15 is Kendra Cessna, who played for you at Fairfield.
Yep.
Nicole Jordan, who played her volleyball at Cisney. She's number 20. Number 33 is Bobby Lake, the tallest player on the floor for either team. She's from Sparta. And the libero is Grace Bora from Fairfield. And Jessica Hughes is the coach, of course, for the Frontier Bobcats. Second match of the season and of the program for both of these teams. We're just about set for action. What are some of the early things that you'll look for here to kind of set the tempo tonight in this one?
I'd really like to see, you know, better ball control from the Bobcats and just to relax and play ball. I think that'll happen here, and they got to be aggressive. They got to swing. If they're just going to give Morthland free balls and tips, it's not going to get down. Morthland's going to play good defense.
All right, we are just about ready for action here. Glad that you've joined us on AreaSports.net. See who's going to get the first serve. Officials are checking some of the numbers. Are the rotations any different at the college level than what they are at the high school level, Chet?
There's a little bit more strategy in it. Mm-hmm. You know, if you have a superior outside hitter or something, the other team really wants to match up and put their, you know, best blocker to get to the front row at the right side against them. So a lot of times you'll see, you know, when I'm watching, like, Illinois on TV, they keep switching it, trying to, you know, outguess the other coach to get the best mismatch they can.
Bobcats will serve first. It's Courtney Kroll, and here comes the serve. It's across, and there's a set, and they get it across. Bobcats now look for the set as Kroll is going to set it. There's a spike. It goes a little bit, a little deep.
Think is in.
Nicole Jordan put it in the corner. Yep. They're going to call it good. Okay. 1-0 Bobcats. Another serve by Kroll. Again, she is from Edgewood, and here's a serve. It's popped up. Now a set. Hit from midpoint back. Kolak gets it, and the Kroll. Now it's bumped and falls to the floor. It's another point for the Bobcats. It's 2-0.
Off to a good start. Attacking at him.
Bobcats trying to keep it deep in that deep line, aren't they?
Look on that back row. There's a big hole right down the line there.
Another good serve. They dig that one out. Here comes the set.
Yep.
Somebody in the net or underneath the net?
No, setter just mishandled that ball. Mm-hmm. Came off her hands. Courtney's serving tough, and Morthland handling it pretty well.
3-0 is our score. Another serve. There's the dig. A set. And that one's pushed across, and it's in as a shot is made there by, I think that's Guerrero, or no, that's a, or no, that's Robbie. Ruth Raby or Robbie. We'll call it Raby from Sparta with the point there. It's 3-1, and the service now by Morthland. And doing the honors will be Rebecca Mosley, formerly from the Lady Foxes of Hamilton
Foxes.
Academy.
Yep.
Kolak gets it across. Here comes the set. Pedke digs it out. Now Kolak gets it across. Morthland on the third hit gets it across, but it's deep. Going to go back to Bobcats and a point for Frontier. They lead it 4-1 here.
the other night that, you know, the, was it the Blue Storm we were playing there from Swick?
Right.
They were just the quicker team. And tonight the Bobcats look like the quicker team.
Nicole Jordan serves this time for the Bobcats. There's a set and the kill. And it's a point for the Patriots. Outside hitter on that one was Sandra Hartline from Cobden. Service coming up now by Ellen Luther from Murray, Kentucky. Serving. And it's across, dug out by Grace Bora. Here's the set and a spike, a block.
Good pass by Grace Bora there, setting up that offense.
Makes it 5-2. Serving now will be Kolak. And she goes a little bit wide on that one. Going to make it 5-3, and it's going to give the service back to Morthland. And this time it'll be Krista Irwin from Fishers, Indiana, doing the serving for them. It's a low serve, hits the net.
If there's one rule change that I absolutely hate in volleyball, it's that.
That one, where it goes across.
If it can hit the net, you ought to be able to block.
Yep.
Otherwise, you don't have a chance sometimes.
Shot very similar to what we see in tennis there, where the ball will hit the top of the tape and fall over, and not much you can do about it. And that's what happened there. Here's Petke bumping it across. Set, and that's across, and back across again. This diving for it was Renner. Bora.
Nice pass by Bora.
To Kroll. There's
oh,
a.
Up.
Oh, boy, they kept it alive.
Nice up.
Bora again. Here's the bump, and there's the spike. Dug out this time by Renner. Back cross again. Longest volley of the match so far.
Somebody needs to terminate.
Petke goes for the kill, but they dig it out. Third hit coming across, and it's in the net. Bobcats get the point. That was a long one.
That's a battle right there. That's a good volley.
Sure was. Makes it 6-4, and it'll be Bobcats serve here. We are in set number one of tonight's collegiate match. Again, both of these programs are new this year, so somebody's going to win their first ever college volleyball match this evening. Here's a serve that is coming up by the Bobcats. It's deep and back across, and it's tipped but falls to the floor. As a Lake and Renner, neither one could control it.
Yeah, that sometimes the block just gets in the way, and right there, if we wouldn't have blocked, we could have passed the ball.
Had the girl right there, didn't we? Yeah. 6-5 the score. Frontier in front. Morthland serving. And a serve this time by Victoria Lara from Texas. Oh, nice spike that time. How about that? Beautiful set and kill that time. As putting away was Alana Renner. She put the hammer down.
Bora has been absolutely fantastic in serve receive. She's putting the ball right on the money.
Makes it 7-5, and now the serve coming up from Renner. Again, she's from Steelville. And here's her serve. It's bumped. There's the set and tipped across him. And the block that time by Bobby Lake. Lake with the block and the point for the Bobcats makes it 8-5, and Renner with another serve. There's the bump, set. That one goes across by Raby. Another set, this time to the outside, and the shot is deep that time.
Yeah, it's out. What's the call? I don't know if it's a touch, but yeah, they're going to say touch.
Okay. So 8-6 is our score. Frontier in front here in set number one with Morthland serving. This time to serve by Hartline. There's the set, and trying to get it across was Bobby Lake, but it was short. It's Courtney Kroll on the set. Makes it 8-7, got another serve coming up from Hartline. This one's dug out by Bora to Kroll. And across it comes. A nice hit that time by Nicole Jordan. What are you seeing so far, Coach?
Well, I think our ball control is a lot better. When we can get into offense and set it up, we've been pretty doggone successful. So
9-7, that one hits the top of the net and goes over, and it's still live.
And
the Bobcats get it across. They stayed with it that time. That one's tipped.
That's
Polak.
Second time that's happened.
Mm-hmm. Went for the block, and it deflected away, and then nobody could get it. 9-8. Serve coming up from Morthland. And this time it's by Holmes. There's a set by Kroll, and the spike by Kolak. And then the block back across Jordan with the kill. Mm-hmm. 10-8. Playing with a lot more confidence, they appear to be, don't they?
Yeah, I think they feel like this is, they know without a doubt this is a team they can beat, and they're wanting to get that first win tonight.
Courtney Kroll ready to serve it for the Bobcats, leading at 10-8 here in set number one. Here it comes across. There's the dig. There's the set. And now the spike. And it is out of the reach. Comes off of Cessna, and then nobody else could get it. Makes it 10-9. Few substitutions
both
here for Morthland.
Both teams have been really good in serve receive so far.
Mm-hmm.
Seen some tough serves, and these teams are locked in.
Rebecca Mosley going to serve it again here for Morthland. There's Kroll on the set, and that one's blocked across. As Nicole Jordan was at the net there for the Bobcats, but it's a tie game now as Morthland gets the point. And again, it'll be Mosley serving. Was hit by Kroll. Here's the set by Kolak, and Pedke gets it across. Now another set, and there's a spike, and it's good kill that time by Victoria Lara, a Patriot player from Texas.
Now this is a tough serve receive for us. We have our setter in serve receive, so we don't have a setter. So
makes it a little bit tougher then, doesn't it?
Yeah, if she passes that first ball, then
I'm not sure
which one. Nicole went and tried to get it there, but then Alyssa said it at the last minute. So.
Yeah. And Morthland taking advantage of that situation on the floor right now by the Bobcats, and they have their first lead of the game at 11-10.
Yeah. Tony's over there. He's getting them going. I would say he would encourage them to serve Courtney there, actually.
How many years has he been coaching?
A long time, probably 80 or 90 at least.
Mm-hmm. He's going to love you for that.
He will. I'm glad we're friends.
I'm glad you are too.
I hadn't seen his team play, obviously, but you kind of know what they look like before you've even seen them, just because you know what
his
teams will do. And, man, they're not going to overwhelm you with, athleticism here, but they're going to play hard, and they're really going to play hard on defense.
There's Pedke on the kill after the set by Kroll, and a good offensive set that time by the Bobcats. Ties it up at 11, and Frontier will be serving it now, and it'll be Nicole Jordan, former Cisney Lion, doing the honors. Here comes cross. There's the dig. And this one's pushed across by Morthland. There's a set by Kroll. And nice little dink across that time. Mm-hmm. Lana Renner.
And see, that was the ball the other night. It was not a good set, and she would swing hard and drill it out of bounds. Right there, she changed up speeds and scored a point for her team.
A little finesse that time.
Nice adjustment.
Sure was. There's a serve. And that one goes deep, but it is in. Got on the back row, nobody home. Found the hole, it's 12-12. Morthland serving. Morthland doesn't have anybody in a libero jersey. Designated as a libero, at least not by a jersey color. That one goes deep. Out of bounds. Another point for Morthland. They've got the lead now at 13-12. We're in the first set. Again, you played 5. And the service this time by Luther. This one's bumped up. Got to have cross the third hit, and they do. There's a set, and that one is off of Kolak and Renner that time. Another point. 14-12, biggest lead of the match for Morthland. Luther serving it again.
Oops, a little wide.
That is wide.
Needed a break there.
Sure did. Makes it 14-13. Bobcats will get it back on the service, and it's going to be Alyssa Kolak. Here's her serve right down the middle. There's a set, and that one's dug out by Kolak. Now to Kroll. Across it comes from Renner. And did that get in? Wow.
I believe so.
Holy cow. Diagonal shot there is in. For Morthland makes it 15-13. And they'll get it back again on the service.
That's Krista Irwin, a 5'5 right side hitter freshman from Fishers, Indiana. Nice little roll shot right to the corner.
And she is serving right now. Bora hits it. Now back across it comes by Renner. There's the dig. And it goes wide. Point for the Bobcats, and they'll have the serve. 15-14. And this time it's going to be Abby Reeves, Wayne City, serving it for the Bobcats. Comes across. There's the bump. A set. And the kill by Hartline. Dug out. Back across. This time Kroll to Lake. And it's a point for the Bobcats.
Good choice there by Lake to go over and two. Kind of caught Morphlin on their heels.
Yep, nobody says you have to wait till three hits.
Nope.
You got a chance there right away, put it away.
Is it a good ball for her to swing at. All tied up here at 15. Be nice to go beat them to 20 here.
Here's the serve by Reeves. Back across. Dug out. Here's Kroll with the set. And the kill by Renner. It's in the net. And it's a point for the Bobcats. 16-15. Very spirited first set here.
Absolutely. We may be here a while.
This we might be. We might be.
Looks like both these teams are in for the fight.
Abby Reeves on the serve. Here it comes. Third hit coming up, and it's low. Another point for the Bobcats. 17-15. Next serve, there's a bump, and that hits the floor. 18-15, putting together a little bit of a run right now and got a timeout on the floor.
Bobcats on a roll.
I want to remind you that this broadcast tonight is made possible by Fairfield Printing and Graphics. They have school gear and team gear for Fairfield, Wayne City, Jasper, Sisney, Jeff, New Hope, and others. They can do T-shirts, sweatshirts, hoodies, letter jackets, as well as banners, signs, vinyl decals, and a variety of other things to show your school spirit or promote your church or your business or other organization. Fairfield Printing and Graphics can be reached at 842-4048. They're located just west of Fairfield on Route 15. Also made possible tonight by Wainwright Propane, as the heating season is just around the corner, believe it or not, and propane prices are lower than they've been in more than 10 years, so you might want to fill up your propane tank before the price goes up and before the demand goes up. Wainwright Propane. Good time to fill up now
and grill out later. It's
That's
too
right.
hot to grill out tonight, isn't it?
It is. Maybe Labor Day we can grill out.
Yep.
Who knows? 18-15, back to action. Bobcats lead up their serving. There's the bump. Now the set. And that one's pushed across. Nice spike that time from the corner.
Renner gets a good ball. Morphlin just doesn't have an answer for her. She's just too big and powerful.
And Courtney Kroll doing a great job on the sets, too. Really, really setting the ball well for Renner. 19-15. Another serve coming up here by Reeves. There's a set. And a spike that time, and a good one. Oh, I'll tell you what, Sandra Hartline from Cobden, she put that one away. Wow. Nice spike that time by Hardline. 19-16.
Making her high school coach Nathan Emmerich very, very happy. He does a great job at Cobden.
That one's pushed across, but a little wide. It's going to be another point for Morthland. Makes it 19-17, and they'll continue to serve as Victoria Lara from Texas is doing the honors right now. We're in the first set. This one comes across, and there's Grace Bora with it to Kroll. And a set and a spike, and it's a good one.
Renner gets us out of it again.
She's on the other side of the net this time, yep. Other side of the court, but still just as effective.
Where we got a, you know, she goes back to serve now. Nicole moves to the front row there at the outside. She's got to stay aggressive.
20-17. Here's a serve and a set. Raby gets it across, and it's tipped and out of bounds, and it's going to be a point for the Patriots. Makes it 20-18, and now they will serve.
We did not go block. Don't know where our middle was there.
There's the serve and the bump. Kroll.
Nice ball.
Across a little deep that time, however, by Jordan. Makes it 20-19. This one's getting tight. Closing stages of the first set. Serve by Hartline. And
that
one is wide.
Right there.
Went wide. 21-19. Looks like Grace Bora going to do the serve now.
She's a good one to have here. She can pick her spot and get Kolak back on the front row there at middle.
Bora the libero for the Cats. And here's a serve. It's nice and low, but it was wide. Did she touch it? Yes, not.
I jinxed her.
That was close, but out of bounds. 21-20. Serving now.
Wow.
It's in the net.
Three misses in a row.
Amazing. 22-20. Some unforced errors here. Serving now will be Courtney Kroll for the Bobcats. This first set on the line. Nice jump serve. There's the bump. There's a set. And a spike. By Irwin's, dug out. Kolak gets it across. There's a bump. Set. Spike again, but Kroll is there. And that one comes across, and it's done by Irwin. Irwin dumps it across, makes it 22-21.
Just can't seem to shake him, you know. Need that one more rotation here, and we get back on the front row.
22-21. Serving now is Mosley again for Morthland. Bora to Kroll. Across this time by Jordan. Here's a set. And that one is deep. Out of bounds. It'll be Bobcats serving with the lead. 23-21. Nicole Jordan will handle the serve. That one's deep. And that was an issue that Coach Hughes talked about the other night. It's too many deep serves in that first match.
You get to 20-20, you can't miss serves. You got to still serve tough, but you got to make sure you get them in. Opens here.
23-22.
Good ball.
Bora to Kroll. And that one's tipped. Is that tipped?
No.
Okay.
Came off her hand funny. 23-23.
All right. We're tied up here. Closing stages of this first set. Another serve by Luther. That was dug out by Kolak. Here's Petke putting it across. Here's a set. And that's pushed across. Kroll has it. Now Petke sets it. And not controlled that time by Renner. 24-23. Set point here for Morthland. In set number one. Served by Luther. And it's in. Let it go, and it fell in for the game winner. Set number one goes to Morthland. It's 1-0, 25-23. Tough one that time.
That's a tough one to swallow. We had that match there. Missed key serve. And
it was eerily similar to that first match the other night.
Yeah.
The second set,
we had that lead, and we got to win the game here. Get that little monkey off our back.
Yep, that is right.
Win the game, then we worry about winning the match.
All right, 25-23 is how set number one goes. Well, if you're a Bobcats fan, you're hoping that this thing's going to go four sets tonight now.
Absolutely.
Because you got to win the best three out of five, so if having lost the first one, the Bobcats need to win the next three.
We want to win the next three right in a row.
Mm-hmm. Coach Hughes talking to them along the sideline, trying to restore their confidence and that sort of thing. Let them know that you got plenty of time to win this thing.
Absolutely. It's like us last night.
You lost the first set last night, right?
Yeah. I told my assistant, I said, well, I just feel like we got that out of the way. You know, we're going to be all right now. And it ended up being okay. They just got to relax and play. If they pass and hit the ball, you know, Courtney sets a good ball, and if they pass and hit the ball, Morphone can't stop them.
Mm-hmm. Yep. This broadcast also made possible by Jagger's Doggy Daycare in Mount Vernon, offering dog grooming, dog obedience training, and daycare for your dog, featuring separate playground areas for small and large dogs. And there's playgrounds both indoors and outdoors at Jagger's Doggy Daycare. You can call them for appointments for grooming or for daycare or dog obedience training classes at 316-7021. That's 316-7021. Or visit their website at jaggersdoggydaycare.com. This broadcast also made possible by the Sports Zone, located on Delaware Street in Fairfield, as they have individualized one-on-one instruction in a variety of sports. Also have a jump program, which is good for a lot of sports, to help with vertical jump, including volleyball, at the Sports Zone, located on Delaware Street in Fairfield. Reminder, too, that you can check the area sports report every weekday morning at 6:35 a.m., 7:35, and 8:35 a.m. on the radio on 90.9 The Vine, as we break down a lot of the scores from local and area sports each and every weekday morning. So join us for the area sports report three times every weekday morning on 90.9 The Vine. Officials checking out all the players are on the floor as the clock winds down here. We're just about ready for set number two to begin. Morthland will be serving first, and doing the honors will be Brianna Holmes. Comes across, dug out. Here's a set by Kroll and Kolak with a hit, but it's deep, out of bounds. 1-0 early lead here for Morthland in the second set. Holmes from Creel Springs.
Played her high school ball at Marion.
Okay. There's the bump, and it's across that time by Reeves. Spike is deep that time by Morthland. Out of bounds, ties the score at 1-1. And it'll be Courtney Kroll serving for the Bobcats.
Need Courtney to get on a run here and get out a nice little lead.
She uses that momentum coming forward on that jump serve, and in the net is Morthland. 2-1 as the point goes to the Bobcats. Yeah, she exerts a lot of energy on that serve, doesn't she?
Yes, she does. She's got good body control. And when it drops like that, it's tough to pass.
Yep.
Has a great serve.
Ace. Ace that time by Kroll, makes it 3-1.
Her math teacher was at my house today talking about her. Said she's just a great kid. He was wanting to come watch her tonight.
That one goes a little bit wide.
Mm-hmm.
Now, she's from Edgewood. Did she play at North Clay?
Yes.
North Clay High School, yeah. 3-2 is the score. Morthland with the service. Bobcats leading it. Mosley will serve it for Morthland. Low serve and couldn't be handled there by Bora. Good placement by Mosley.
This is that serve receive where we have Courtney in serve receive.
Mm-hmm.
So need to get out of it quick.
3-3 is our score. Mosley again. Bora digs that one out. And there's a set. And Pedke puts it across. And there's a spike dug out. And that is blocked across by Lara. Makes it a 4-3 lead for Morthland. Mosley again to serve for the Patriots. Kolak tips it. There's Kroll. Now to Pedke. Dug out. Here's a set. And a spike is good that time by Ellen Luther from Murray, Kentucky.
Mm-hmm.
No doubt about that one.
Nope.
5-3. Morthland in the lead here in set number two. Again, it's Mosley. That was kind of a knuckleball serve that time.
Came off her hand a little funny.
Mm-hmm.
We needed that, though. That gets Renner in the game.
5-4, and that'll take Nicole Jordan back to the service line. Here's her serve. It's deep, and it's out. Another long serve by the Bobcats. 6-4. And now serving for Morthland will be Ellen Luther of Murray, Kentucky. Her serve's in the net. Another unforced error. 6-5. Alyssa Kolak now will serve from the right side of that service line. And she puts it in the net. Holy cow. Seven, five. Quite a pattern going here.
Yes. Not good ball right now.
Krista Irwin serving. She gets it across. There's the bump. Pedke with a set. And a cross by Kroll. Dug out. Set. Attempted block, but
that's a big block for the Bobcats there with Lake and Renner.
And
the biggest I think we can put up.
Yeah, that is 7-6 now, I believe. That score correct? Coming back to serve will be Abby Reeves from Wayne City. 7-6, Bobcats trail it by one. Here's the serve, comes across, there's the dig, the set. And a spike dug out by Bora, set by Kroll, and a spike is in, this time by Renner.
He did that.
Ties the score at 7-7. Frontier still serving. Abby Reeves doing the honors.
We're on a run in game one with Abby serving. Hopefully we can do that again here.
Mm-hmm. Here's a set. And dug out, but three hits. Point for the Bobcats.
Cleared the net.
8-7. Frontier back in the lead. Another serve from Reeves. It's a cross. Dug out by Kroll. The set. Now Kroll gets it across. There's a set by Morthland. And that one's deep.
It'll be.
Makes it 9-7. Bobcats trying to put together a run here.
On a roll.
Lost that first set narrowly 25-23 if you just joined us. Served by Reeves. There's the bump. Set. And that one's tipped across. Nice dig.
Nice play.
Across.
Oh.
Good play that time.
Nice swing by Green from the back row.
Sarah Green from Wayne City. Put that one away. Makes it 10-7.
A nice set by Courtney.
Sure was. Good job of keeping that alive. There's the serve and a set. And that one's blocked.
That's Courtney again.
Nice block by Courtney Kroll makes 11-7, and that's going to be a timeout for Morthland College. Tony Phelps wants to talk about it.
Randy, you were talking about rotations earlier, you know, and like when you're setting them up. Well, here, this is twice now where with Abby scoring, they've had trouble getting out of it, you know, and that's like last night in our third match, we got out to an 11-0 run, and, you know, Edwards County was just in a serve receive. You got six serve receives, and some of them you like as a coach, and some of them we got to have. We don't really like them. It's just their best option. And I can tell you right now, Tony doesn't like this one, but his girl's got to get him out of it.
So you can't get out of it by calling a timeout.
Well, it's a good thing. You can try to ice that server.
Yeah,
or,
right.
But you're
still in the same rotation.
You can move your girls around a little bit, but, you know, they've still got to stay in that order when they start.
Gotcha. All right, so Abby Reeves still serving for the Bobcats, who lead at 11-7 here in set number two. There's the bump, set. And that one's in the net. No good by Chris Irwin, and a point for the Bobcats makes it 12-7. Another one coming from Reeves. That's a deep ball. It's handled. And that's dug out by Kroll. Now across it goes by Renner. There's a bump, a set. Dinked across, saved. Lake gets it across. There's a set by Holmes. Dug out of there by
nice
Bora.
Pass by Bora.
Oh, Renner, a little deep that time by Renner. Well, that stops the streak. Makes the score 12-8.
A good run, though. Gave us a four-point cushion there. We got a...
Victoria Lara from Texas serving now for Morthland. Dug out by Bora. And put across there rather quickly. And
it's a good play by Courtney.
Sneaky by Courtney Kroll. 13-8. Serve back to the Bobcats. It's Renner serving it. Here's a set. And a spike by Hartline. Dug out by Bora. Back across by Lake, and it's a point for the Bobcats. 14-8. 6-point lead, the biggest lead of this set.
Just proves you don't have to hit it hard every time. You just good ball control and dropped it right in the hole.
Renner with another serve for front. Gets it across, there's the bump, now the set. And that spike is bumped up. There's a set by Kroll. And the spike is a good one. Gets it across, though, Lake to Kroll. And she puts it a little bit wide, but they're saying it's touched.
I think Morthland was
in the net.
Number 11.
All right.
For Morthland.
15-8. 7-point lead here for the Bobcats in set number two after dropping the first one, 25-23. Served by Renner. That one looked like it was going to go deep. Here comes the third hit. It's in the net. 16-8. Bobcats feeling it now. Alana Renner again. Dinked across and put back, but a little bit wide by Kroll. That'll give the point to Morthland and give them the serve at 16-9.
Renner really served tough for us there. Put us on a nice run.
Hartline serves it. There's Kroll with a set and Lake with the spike, but it's a little deep. 16-10. There's the dig by Cessna, and it's across. Bobcats point. 17-10.
Nice anticipation by Courtney. Wasn't a good pass, and she scored a point on it.
Grace Bora serving now for the Bobcats. Well, that one's nice and low.
Nice serve.
And it's wide on the return. 18-10.
Tony wants another timeout.
Okay. Going to talk things over here. We're in set number two. 18-10, Frontier leading it. After Morthland won the first one, 25-23. Chet Snyder's with us here on the broadcast. He is the head coach of the Lady Mules of Fairfield. They won last night, a big match, big win over Edwards County. And going back through all of your years of coaching, I'd say Edwards County's probably got you more than you got them.
Oh, absolutely. We hadn't got them in a long time.
Yeah.
Got them. I'd only beat them three times, you know, my team's had since I've been coaching, and those were all early. Those teams late, whew, they were mighty. You know, the last few years they've placed at the state tournament, so we've been knocked out. I think the last few years I had teams that could have won a lot of regionals, but got matched up with them. So it was a nice win last night. Really proud of my girls.
Definitely. All right, Grace Bora is going to be serving here when we come back to action. And that one's deep, and it's out. Makes it 18-11, and they give Morthland the serve now. Brianna Holmes trots back there. Comes across, there's the dig, put back across. Set by Kroll, and it's across this time by Reeves. Morthland gets across, the dig by Bora. And a spike. But somehow Morthland keeps it alive. There's a high ball. Kroll.
Boom.
Kolak. Good teamwork there. Kolak and Kroll together.
You could see when Kolak made that pass, they were going to go for a three. That's that little shoot set there to the other side of the circle, and she smacked that thing.
19-11. Nice play that time by the Bobcats. Some good teamwork. Courtney Kroll going to be serving now. And that's a good deep ball, and it's in. Couldn't handle that one. 20-11. Kroll again to serve. There's a dig. Set. Dinked across. Boris got it. Set by Kroll. Spiked by Kolak. Is it
in? In the corner. Yeah.
Great. Great shot by Alyssa Kolak. 21-11. Good net play that time by Kolak. Kroll with another serve. That one's dug out. Here's a set. Spike is tipped. Kroll with a set. And it's pushed across that time. Set by Morthland. And that one's in on a nice play by Ellen Luther. Found the hole.
Yep.
Makes it 21-12. And Morthland will be serving.
Sarah Green has come in for the Lady Bobcats and done a really, really good job.
She's another player from Wayne City. Here's a serve by Mosley. Set by Kroll. Here's Pedke on the spike. That's dug out. Now back across in the net. Point for the Bobcats. Makes it 22-12. And it'll be Sarah Green serving for Frontier. Gets it across. Almost mishandled. Dug out by Kolak. The set by Kroll. Pedke with a kill. That's tipped. That's a point for the Bobcats. 23-12.
Pedke with a nice swing. I'd like to see her get a few more touches. I like the way she swings the ball.
Green again on the serve. Oh, that one's a little deep. It's going to give it back to the Patriots of Morthland. Gives them the point, 23-13, and Bobcats lead it. Serving is, that's Luther, I think. Yeah, Luther serving for Morthland. Just set by Kroll and kind of mishit that time.
Yep.
Kind of a double hit, I guess, huh?
Yeah, and sometimes that's just because the ball got wet, you know, and especially when the gym's this hot.
Yeah, yep. Timeout on the court again, 23-14 is our score.
Courtney Atow there. That's a good call by Coach.
2 points away from winning this set number two. It sure would be sweet to get this one.
Absolutely. And that, you know, pulls us even and just gives us confidence, you know. Getting that monkey off our back of our first game victory in Bobcat history.
And then it comes down to the best two out of three if you're tied up.
Kind of back to a high school match there.
Yeah, that's right. Sure does.
This is all just warm-ups.
Okay.
All right. Our preview. Two of my seniors turned 18 yesterday, and I told them, I think they thought they were going to get in trouble even after we lost that first game. I said, you guys, you just want to play more on your birthday, don't you? That's all it is. Go three. They're like, yeah, right, Coach.
Oh, that's funny. Yeah, this weekend you were at that Casey Westfield tournament. I mean, a lot of teams up there playing in that.
Yeah. Mount Zion's there. They're a good 3A team. Hartsburg-Emden finished third in state last year, and they've got everybody back. They're a really good team.
Back to live action. There's back the kill by Kolak after the set by Kroll. And it's 24-14. It's set point here in set number two.
Kolak was so much better that time across the court. She got that time across the front row when she was in. Three kills from her.
There's the serve, the dig, set. That one's deep.
And there it is.
That's the set point right there. And we're even at one set apiece.
Bobcats win.
25-14 the win that time by the Bobcats. So we are tied at one apiece. Be about a 3 minute break here, and we'll start action in set number three. Got a good one going here. Well, volleyball is a game of adjustments, just like basketball or football or anything else. So what do you think both coaches are thinking about right now as far as what they could do to some adjustments here?
You know, if I'm the Bobcat coach, I'm really, really happy. You know, we had that big lead in game one, and, you know, you let it slip away, and then you can either pout and not play hard, or you can come back and kick some butt. And, boy, that's what they did. You know, if I'm – Tony, boy, he's thinking we can't do that. We have way too many errors on easy plays and miss serves, stuff that his teams don't do. And I'm sure they're getting a little talking to right now.
All right. Well, we want to remind you that this broadcast is made possible by, find my list here. Did my list blow away? I don't know.
Oh, yeah, it's down there.
Okay, all right, appreciate it. Made possible by Wainwright Propane. And, again, I want to remind you that the propane prices are lower than they've been in some 10, 15 years. And propane prices could be going back up again as the demand increases as we get closer to the winter heating season. And as a result of that, you might want to think about getting your propane tank refilled at Wainwright Propane. Also, they have fishing supplies, all half price. If you like fishing, they've got lures and poles and rods and reels and all kinds of different kinds of bait and things like that for your fishing gear. It's really not the end of the fishing season yet. Still got time to do a lot of fishing, and you can get your fishing gear at half price. That's right. It's all 50% off right now at Wainwright Propane in Fairfield. And this broadcast also made possible by the Sport Zone, located on Delaware Street in Fairfield, where they have individualized instruction in a variety of sports. Baseball, softball, basketball, and, of course, speed and agility drills, including the jump. You have the jump classes or the jump training, which really helps to increase your vertical leap, your vertical jump, and it can help you in a variety of different sports, including volleyball. So learn how to jump off your other foot and improve your coordination and so many other things at the Sports Zone in Fairfield. Fairfield Printing and Graphics also making tonight's broadcast possible. And they have school gear and team gear for Fairfield, Wayne City, Jasper, Sisney, Jeff, New Hope, and others. They can do T-shirts, sweatshirts, hoodies, letter jackets, as well as banners, signs, vinyl decals, and a variety of other things to show your school spirit or to promote your church, your business, or other organization at Fairfield Printing and Graphics. They're located just west of Fairfield on Route 15. They can be reached at 842-408-4248. Play the best of five here at the college level. You really want to win this set number three to be in control of the match.
Absolutely. That's really important in college ball, winning. You're tied 1-1. The statistics on the team that wins this is huge.
Courtney Crow with a great opening serve there for the Bobcats. Gives Frontier an early 1-0 lead. Another serve coming up. That one's dug out. It's wide. It's point number two. Serve comes across with pretty good speed, and she keeps it low.
Mm-hmm. Courtney's been outstanding for us.
That one's deep. There's a set. And was she in the net?
No, they called a
or underneath the net.
Double hit on her.
Okay.
Her hands did not contact the ball at the same time.
3-0 now. Good start here for the Bobcats. Courtney Kroll again on the serve. That one is dug out and couldn't handle it, though. She's serving those to the deep to the back line, and that one mishandled by Hartline.
And what she's doing, that's a tough topspin serve, and it's hard to do. You miss a lot. She hadn't missed tonight. I mean, she's been money on it.
That one's bumped. Now a set. And a spike is wide. Out of bounds.
Nice start for the Bobcats.
5-0. Kroll again. Winds up on that jump serve. Gets it across. Here comes a set. And the spike this time is dug out.
By Cessna.
Kroll with the set. Yep. We got a whistle. And a double hit again.
Yeah, that ball was back behind her head. Kind of just didn't get it at the same time. Good run, though.
Mm-hmm. Point for Morthland makes it 5-1, and Mosley will serve it for the Patriots. Her serve's dug out by Bora. Here's Kroll on the set, and there's a spike. And that's a good point, as getting across was Nicole Jordan for Bobcats. 6-1. That's some substitutions here.
That brings Renner in.
Mm-hmm. She'll come to the front line. And serving it will be Nicole Jordan. And that one's handled. Here's a set. And the spike is blocked by Kolak. Bumped by Bora. And there's a spike again by Kolak. Dug out. Set. Spike again. Dug out again by Jordan this time. And point's going to go to Morthland.
Tough call. Kolak was working hard there.
6-2. Serving at this time will be Luther for Morthland. That one's in the net. 7-2. Grace Bora checks out, and Bobby Lake checks in for the Bobcats. Alyssa Kolak will serve it. Almost mishandled. Now they push it across, but it's wide. It's a point for Frontier. 8-2. Kolak will serve again. But you enjoyed coaching her, didn't you?
Yeah, she was one of the best middles I ever coached.
That one's dug across. Here's Kroll on the set. And there's a Renner on the spike, but it goes wide. And it'll be Morthland's point, and they'll serve it.
Kolak, undersized, you know, mm-hmm. for a true middle, but man, she jumps well and is so strong.
Yeah, she's listed at 5'9", but she plays bigger than that.
Absolutely.
8-3 is our score. Here's a serve this time by Irwin. Dug out by Bora. Set by Kroll. The spike that time by Jordan. And that's a point for the Patriots. 8-4. Irwin again serving it for Morthland. Low serve that's dug out. Curl with the set. There's a spike by Lake. And that's the point for the Bobcats. 9-4.
Lake had a good swing there on that outside rotation.
Lake is from Sparta, and they also have Ruth Raby from Sparta on the Morthland squad as well. 9-4 is our score. Abby Reeves serving it now for the Bobcats. There's a set, and that's blocked by Lake. Big block, makes it 10-4. That's what 6-3 will do for you right there.
Absolutely.
Reeves got on a bit of a run earlier with her serve. Hopefully going to do that again. We got another timeout on the floor. 10-4 here in set number three. If you just joined us, we're even at one set apiece. Frontier had the early lead for much of that first set, Chet, but then some unforced errors late in the set of set number one allowed Morthland to open the door and get back in, and they end up winning that one 25-23.
Yeah, just kind of let that first one slip away. But like I said, I love the way the Bobcats responded in game two. You know, you can kind of be down, and that'll get you in game two. Or they came back a fire, and, you know, kind of made them mad, and they responded really well. So keeping it rolling here in game three.
Yes. All right. Back to live action. Abby Reeves serving it for the Bobcats, who lead it here 10-4 in set number three. There's a bump and a set and a spike. It's blocked. I'm not sure which one got it, whether it was Lake or Curl.
I think it was Curl.
11-4. Good point that time from the Bobcats. Reeves again to serve. There's a bump and a set. That one's pushed across. Curl with a set. There's a spike by Renner.
Renner. When she gets everything just right, man, she is tough.
Mm-hmm. She was wound up that time. 12-4. Another good serve. There's a set. And that one is blocked back by Lake. It's dug out by Kroll. Back across, and it hits the floor. Was that Sarah Green to put
Sarah
those?
Green again.
Okay.
She's been money denied. Everything she touches does well.
Yeah, those shots from the middle of the floor. Good placement. 13-4. There's a set, and that spike dug out. Kroll sets it again. There's Renner with a little finesse shot. Put it where they ain't.
Absolutely.
You had both defenders at the net. She realized that, and she just dinked it right across.
Well, she can hit the ball so hard. Mm-hmm. You know, Morflin's back, you know, down, ready for, you know, a tough hit. And that's a smart thing to do. Everybody's down knowing that power's coming, and, man, you just barely touch it.
Yeah, anticipating the strong kill, and instead she just dinks it right over their head. 14-4 is our score now. Good play. Hey, also want to tell you that Gene Kolak at the Man Cave, he's a big supporter of Bobcats volleyball.
He's here tonight.
He is here tonight. Does he have camera in hand tonight?
He usually does.
He doesn't usually go anywhere without it, does he?
One of the best picture takers in Wayne County.
Yes, and he's also the lead instructor of the construction tech classes at Frontier Community College. And, by the way, there's still time to enroll in those classes, and that's where students get a ton of instruction on basic framing, construction techniques, roofing, electric, plumbing, finishing, and more. You can sign up your son or grandson in the construction tech classes at Frontier. Just visit the admissions office at the college or call 842-3711. Back to live action. Another serve by Reeves, and that one's dug. They got to get it across. They do. Ooh, that was deep. Bora bumps it. Now across by Here comes a set and a spike.
Oh.
Blocked.
We were there, just a little.
Yep.
Throw it right through the hole there.
14-5 is the score. Morthland will get the serve back. And serving at this time is Lara. That ball's just a little bit deep. Makes it 14-6. This one's bumped up by Green. Got to get it across. Renner does. And a bump on the other side. A set. And a spike. Dug out by Bora. And there's Lake with a good smash. Bobby Lake puts it away. 15-6.
Bora played well the other night against Swick, but not near like tonight. She's just played super. Passed the ball right on point to Courtney. If you give Courtney a good ball, you're going to get a good set.
Renner with the serve this time. There's the set and the spike. It's dug out by Green. There's Kroll back to Green. She'll put it across. Bumped up. Now back across. Here's Kroll with a set and Lake with a spike. Is it wide? Yep.
Mine just says out.
Yep, a little bit wide. Makes it 15-7. Morthland will be serving after getting that point. And doing the serving will be Hartline, again from Cobden. Green gets it across. There's a set. Spike, that's deep. Point for the Bobcats.
No touch. I don't think we touched it either.
16-7. It's going to take Grace Bora back to the end line to serve it up. For Frontier. We're in set number three. We're tied at one set apiece.
Ooh, it's almost a good play there by Holmes.
Another good point there.
Handle of the ball. 10-point cushion here. We've got to finish this off.
Can't let up on the pedal, though, can you?
Nope. Momentum can change in this game so quick.
Bora with the serve. Here's a set, and that one's dinked across. Kroll tried to set it for Green, but it's in the net. Makes it 17-8. Service will go back to Morthland. Holmes will serve it. It's a low ball, dug out by Kroll. Kolak gets it across. Here's a set. Spike, dug out by Bora. Bumped by Kroll and across. Morthland. Bora again to Kroll. And good hit by Green. Still alive. Third hit won't go.
Out.
It goes wide. Wow, good point that time for the Bobcats. What do you think, Coach?
Good rally there. Both teams made some exceptional plays to keep that ball alive several times. Glad the Bobcats came out on top.
18-8 is our score. Frontier with the lead, and serving it now is going to be Courtney Kroll.
She's been very successful there tonight, and that's why.
Good jump serve. Dug out by Bora. There's Kroll in the set, and there's good placement by Alyssa Kolak. 19-8. Bobcats playing with a lot more confidence right now. As Coach was talking about, they were afraid of hitting the ball out the other night and said that in that first match. Not seeing that now. Seeing some confidence out there. Oh, nice dig by Bora. Across by Kolak. Oh, just a little bit deep. Wow. Good effort that time. Grace Bora. She, by the way, has an injured wrist. She has that wrist wrapped and taped tonight. I asked her about that before the match, and she said that when she was diving for a ball the other night, she kind of sprained that wrist a little bit, hurt some tendons a little bit. But she's a gamer. She's playing.
Absolutely.
You know that. You coached her.
She's my libero for 2 years.
probably couldn't keep her off the floor, could you?
Well, I like seeing her make that play. Her specialty really serve, receive, and serving.
Mm-hmm.
And I always wanted her to be a little bit more aggressive on defense, and that right there was just what she did.
Yeah. Bora to Kroll to Petke. Set on the other side. And is it out? Nicole Jordan did not touch it. It's 20-10. And serving it will be Jordan. And she played her high school volleyball at Sisney. Her serve is in the back line. There's a set. And it's dumped across by Lara. She's from Texas. 20-11. And serving now will be, well, they got number 15 out there serving, and she's not in our program. Apologize for that. For you Morthland fans. There's a set and a spike by Renner. Dumped across, and that's a point for the Patriots. 20-12.
We have two 10s. I'm not sure this.
Well, there was an 11 out there earlier.
This the young lady from San Elmo.
Okay.
I could be wrong, but this could be Elizabeth Guerrero.
Was in the net by Jordan.
Played them in a summer match.
Okay.
Last summer, and I think I remember her, but I could be wrong.
20-13, couple of points here by the Patriots all of a sudden. Here is a set, and Renner with a spike. Back across. Kroll with a set. Petke with the kill. Dug out. Back across again, and another point for Morthland. They're on a run right now. It's 20-14.
Yeah.
You talked about momentum changing.
Explain it. Like, mm-hmm. What changed in the gym, you know, and then.
Yep.
Seemed like, you know, the Bobcats could do nothing wrong, and Morthland could do nothing right, and all of a sudden it switched.
Bora to Kroll to Renner. Across. Set, spike, dug out again. There's Kroll, puts it across. She's going to say that she's in the net.
Number two, they say.
Yep. Okay. 20-15. It's a 5-point run here by the Patriots. Bora to Kroll to Renner. No doubt about that one. You put that one away.
Remember the other night against Swick, I said, I don't know why the Bobcats keep serving rockers, you know, the libero.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Right there, I don't know why they serve Bora. She's been really solid in serve receive.
Kolak on the serve this time for the Bobcats. That one's dumped across. Dug out by Kroll. Across by Renner. Here's a dig, a set, and pushed across, but two hits. A double hit gives a point to the Bobcats, 22-15.
Kolak again serving. Kolak can finish this out here. We handled the run.
Another good serve. There's the bump. That's across.
Oh.
And, well.
Lake was right there.
Lake
just
couldn't control it. Yep. 22-16. Back to Morthland for the serve now. It'll be Irwin. We are in set number three for this best of five. One of these new college programs going to win their first ever collegiate volleyball match. Still alive by Morthland. Got to get it across. They do. Here's Petke. And that comes back to Kroll. Across. Dug out by Bora. And put away at the net by Lara. 22-17. Getting too close for comfort here.
Victoria all the way from Laredo, Texas.
Might have some relatives watching online right now. I'm sure they enjoyed that. Serve this time by Irwin. Couldn't handle it. 22-18. Again, another run by Morthland. They were down 20-10. Now it's 22-18. Bora digs that one out to Kroll. Got to get it across. Here it comes. It's in the net instead by Reeves. 22-19. Good timeout here by Coach Hughes.
Yeah, just got to get the girls under Kroll, get a little game plan here to run a little play. Like to get a quick ball. It seems like anytime we've set something up, you know, fast, quick tempo, we've had success. So got to get a good pass and have Courtney make a good choice. Then we'll go serve.
All right. 22-19 is our score. Morthland will be serving. Down by just three now. They were down by 10 earlier in this set. We're tied at one set apiece. Again, both Morthland and Frontier, brand new volleyball programs this year. Morthland had to go a little out of the area to recruit their players. They've got some out-of-state players on the squad tonight that we've told you about.
Yeah, Morthland's a newer, you know, a newer school. I think it's not as proven, you know, as Frontier. I know they're both first-year programs, but
yeah, Morthland's
kind of
also a relatively new school.
Hard
yeah.
for mm-hmm. you know Tony to get girls to come there.
And that one mishandled by Bora. Uncharacteristic there. 22-20. It's Irwin girl from Fishers, Indiana. She's a nice hard serve. Another one. Dug out by Pedke. To Kroll. Got to get it across. It's Renner. Set at the net. Across. Oh, couldn't get it across that time. 22-21. Getting intense here in the Bobcat den. That one's hit by Bora.
There's a good foul by Bora.
Lake with the spike. There's a set.
Oh.
Back across.
Yeah.
Double hit that time. Well, that breaks the streak. They were having a hard time handling the serve of Irwin.
Nice to get her. And this is Reeves. This is where we've scored points with Reeves serving. So.
Mm-hmm. 23-21. Abby Reeves serving for Frontier. He gets it across. Here's the set. The spike dug out by Bora to Kroll to Renner. Bumped. Set. Spike, nice dig. Another set, got to get it across. Here comes Renner, it's wide.
Man, can't do that.
23-22 as Renner couldn't control it. Serving now will be Lara for Morthland. Bobcats leading it by one. The dig. Push and a point by Morthland. We're tied at 23-23. Lara with another serve.
Good gets pass by Bora.
There's the spike. They keep it alive in the net, and it's a point for the Bobcats. Set point, 24-23, set point. Bobcat serving it, and
Renner
it'll be
serving.
Renner.
Need to do it right here.
It'll be Renner. Everybody on the edge of their seat here. There's a set. And it's put away. Put away by Lake. Bobby Lake with a set point. And the Bobcats win set number three and now lead it 2-1. Wow.
Wow, we needed that. That got a little too tight.
Man,
there.
Oh, man. It was 20-10. 20-10, Chet. And they got it back to 23-23. And finally, the Bobcats get the final 2 points and win that one 25-23. Wow. Yeah, that was pretty tough. So we've had two games of 25-23, one that's been lost, one that's been won by the Bobcats, and then the game in between. So now we're 2-1, and we talked how important it was to win that third set because
now it's do or die for Morthland.
Yeah.
You know, Bobcats got a little cushion here.
Mm-hmm.
But, of course, you want to get it done in four here.
Yeah, you don't want it to go to a fifth set because if it does go to a fifth set, well, first of all, it's just 15 points or win by two. It's a shorter set. So you want to try to take care of business.
A lot can go wrong and happen in that.
Oh, yeah, in a short set like that. It sure can. So you want to try to get it done now. They got 2 minutes counting down on the clock before the start of set number four. Again, this broadcast made possible by Fairfield Printing and Graphics. They have school gear and team gear for Fairfield, Wayne City, Jasper, Sisney, Jeff, New Hope, and others. They can do T-shirts, sweatshirts, hoodies, letter jackets, as well as banners, signs, vinyl decals, and a variety of other things to show your school spirit or promote your church, or your business, or other organization. Rusty and the gang at Fairfield Printing and Graphics can be reached at 842-4048. They're located just west of Fairfield on Route 15. Again, the number is 842-4048 for Fairfield Printing and Graphics. Want to remind you again also to join us for the Sports Couch each and every Saturday morning as we talk local and area sports. It's 90 minutes of local sports talk. We visit with many coaches throughout the area. And we talk, this time of year we talk a lot of football, but we talk some other sports as well. On the Sports Couch every Saturday morning from 8:30 until 10 on 90.9 The Vine Radio and also here on AreaSports.net. Fairfield Mules football team lost a tough game at Chester the other night, Chet, and they're hoping to bounce back here in week number two.
Absolutely. Long trip down to Chester.
Man.
I think Mules were a little disappointed. You know, I think we have a pretty high-powered offense, but Chester was tremendous. That's the best Black Diamond team I've seen since we've been in the Black Diamond.
How about the burner kit?
He's
he's the real deal, isn't he?
He looked fake out there, actually. He looked
so good he was fake.
He's so big and fast. It's one thing to be, you know, that big, but when you're that fast, too.
Hey, when you can chase down Wyatt Bora.
Right, he's a game changer.
Well, you could chase down Wyatt Bora, a guy who qualified for the sprints in state, and chase him down from that many yards back, not only tackle him, but punch the ball out and recover it.
Yeah. Absolutely. I think the Mules will be all right this week. I think home crowd, you know.
Yeah.
Christopher coming in here.
Yeah.
They'll be pretty hungry.
You can't take Christopher lightly, though. I mean, you can't take anybody lightly, but it'll be good to be at home and playing in the train yard. And I'm sure the hometown fans will be out in force Friday night to support the Mules. All right, set number four. About to get underway. It'll be Morthland serving at first. And here is Kolak on the kill. And it's uncontrollable. It's a point for the Bobcats to start things off here. 1-0. Can't say enough about Courtney Kroll and her setting. I'll tell you what. She's
been the best player on the floor tonight.
She's talking to the official right now. Not sure what that's about. But what do you think?
We're going to replay that for some reason. Not quite sure what the deal is there.
Somebody not ready?
I don't know if the official is ready.
Okay, so it's no point. So we'll start it over again. And it'll be Holmes serving it for Morthland. There's a dig. Kroll with the set. And there's a spike by Kolak, but it's wide right. 1-0 Morthland. And they'll serve it again. Holmes. It's dug out by Reeves. There's Kroll to Kolak. Dug out by Bora to Kroll. And a good set that time to Nicole Jordan, and she put it away.
That gets Courtney back to serve in probably our best rotation we've had.
Chance for you at home to get a good look at this jump serve by Courtney Kroll. That one's dug out. Got to get it across. They do. Bora goes and chases that one down. Across by Kolak. Here's a set and dinked across. Good recovery by Kroll. Bumped up by Pedke. Now across but deep.
Deep from Cessna.
From Cessna. Two to one.
Mosley back to serve. Her high school coach, Jason Hall, is quite proud of her. And I jinx her.
Right in the net it goes.
He wouldn't have been happy with that.
2-2 is our score. Your mules, your lady mules and those lady foxes have had some spirited volleyball battles over the last few years, too.
We have.
You really have.
Some tremendous volleyball between us two. Always fun to play the foxes.
Good race in the Black Diamond, always. Renner with the spike. Recovers. Now across from Pedke. She puts it down, and it's tied at 2-2. No, it's 3-2 now. 3-2
good
in favor.
Choice by Kroll there.
3-2 Frontier. Bobcats serving in the person of Nicole Jordan. Set number four. Frontier leads it 2-1. Here's the bump, and tried to dink it across, but hits the floor.
That's a perfect pass, like, for Illinois, because, you know, their setter is 6-2.
Yeah.
So that's just right where she wants it.
Yeah. Yeah, you enjoy watching Illinois volleyball,
absolutely,
don't you?
Absolutely.
Yeah. What a facility they have there. Oh, my goodness.
It's really nice. Huff is fun to go watch a game in, and, you know, the Illini, the Spike squad is second to none, and they're loaded this year. We'll see. They will be disappointed if they don't win at all.
Obviously favored in the Big Ten.
No.
Nope, they're not?
Nah, Penn State? They've won four out of the last six national championships.
Is that right? Okay.
They're really good, but I think the Big Ten has eight schools ranked in the top 25.
That's amazing. Point went to the Bobcats. It's 5-3 as serving is Alyssa Kolak. There's a bump, and that one gets away, and it's another point for Frontier, 6-3. Bobcats would love nothing more than to win this set and win
absolutely
the match right
push
now.
Push on right here.
Mm-hmm.
Can't let Morthland get back on a hot streak like they did earlier.
Kolak with the serve. Oh, that's
right
in. That's in. They let it go, and it fell right in. Good play by the Bobcats as Kolak with a good trajectory on that one. Time out. Tony Phelps from Morthland. Well, what's he telling his girls now?
I would say, you know, ball control. When they have good ball control, when they're playing good defense, play really well, play with a lot of emotion, and they're just not big enough to make those kind of errors. You know, they don't have size. They don't have a terminator, like, you know, like someone like Brenner who can get you out of stuff. And so he's still teaching. Look at him over there. Like, he's a teacher, you know.
Oh, sure.
He loves the game of volleyball. He's done so much for the game of volleyball in Southern Illinois.
Well, I'm sure the folks at Morthland College are thrilled to have him.
Oh,
to start their program.
What a find to start your program. You know, who would not want Tony Phelps to be able to come and start your program? And he's a great man of character and integrity.
And that's so important, too. Alyssa Kolak serving for the Bobcats. It's a good one. There's a set. It's dinked across. And it's point for the Patriots.
Nice little quick tempo play by the Patriots, and Bobcats just were not ready there. A little caught off guard.
Good try by Courtney Kroll. She did all she could diving for that. 7-4 is our score. Serving it now is Irwin. She was tough the last time she was serving it.
Nice pass by Nicole.
Renner.
Out. Good swing. That's the first time they've showed that out of that serve receive, that slide to Brent. I like that a lot.
8-4, and looks like Renner will be serving now. Is that right?
No, Reeves comes in.
Reeves comes in to serve. Okay. Abby Reeves from Wayne City. 8-4 Bobcats. Set number four. Here's a set and a spike, and it's a point for the Patriots. 8-5. Morthland again will get the serve. It'll be Victoria Lara. That one's across. Put across from the back line by the Bobcats. It's 9-5. Now the serve by Alana Renner. Again, she's from Steelville. Ooh, a little deep that time. Nine-six. Cessna checks into the game for the Bobcats, replacing Renner. Hardline serving now for the Patriots. Dug out by Bora. There's a set and put across. Block at the net is good by Bobby Lake. Courtney Kroll also there. 10-6. And we have Bora serving now. Grace Bora. And that one could not be controlled. 11-6. Another good serve by Bora. They get it across on the third hit. And nice combo there by Kolak and Kroll working together at the net, Coach.
Anytime either team has ran quick stuff, they score. So you just have to have a good enough pass to run it. That when both teams pass the ball well, they're scoring on their quick stuff.
Makes it 12-6. Bora still serving for the Bobcats. There's a dig, set. Raby puts it across. It's dug out. Here's a set and a spike that time, which is good by Jordan. Good kill by Jordan that time, 13-6. Bobcats trying to keep it rolling here. Bora again to serve.
Nice serve.
Oh, that was a low one that time, wasn't it? Third hit, they get it across. Oh. Bora, Upman got away from him. 13-7, that stops the streak and gives the ball back over to Morthland on the serve. When it's really hot like this in the gym, what do you do for your girls in this situation? I guess you just try to keep them as hydrated as you can, huh?
Yeah, a lot of summer preparation, too, with that. Mm-hmm. They're used to it. They played
because
the
of working in here in the summer when it's hot? Okay, yeah. 14-7.
They got to take care of themselves and drink lots of water.
Point for the Bobcats. Courtney Kroll going to serve now. We are in set number four. Kroll from North Clay High School. Good jump serve. Across, dug out by Cessna. There's Kroll on the set. There's a spike. But it goes deep. On the hit by Jordan, it'll be the point to the Patriots, and Morthland will be serving. 14-8 our score. Serving this time will be Mosley, former Lady Fox from McLeansboro.
Yeah, there she goes. That's making Coach happy.
Pedke on the spike. Kolak on the hit. Back across, dug out by Cessna. There's Kroll with the set, and dinked across. Oh, they kept it alive. Kroll puts in the back row. Still alive. Bora to Kroll. Oh. And couldn't control the spike that time was Jordan.
Nice rally there by both teams. Both teams making some really good defensive plays. Kendra Cessna in there with a couple nice digs for the Bobcats. Mosley with a nice dig for the Patriots.
14-9. There's a dig. Kroll with the set. Pedke with a spike. It's dug out. Still alive. That one's deep. I'll make it 15-9. And Bobcats will be serving. And coming into serve is Sarah Green. Sarah from Wayne City, as we said earlier. And here's a serve. It's crossed. Set. Spike. That was a good one. Put away that time by Ellen Luther. She's from Murray, Kentucky. Makes it 15-10. Patriots will serve. Got some moisture on the floor. Got to wipe up. Here's a serve from the Patriots. Dug out by Kolak. And she tries to hit it across after the set, but it's in the net. It's 15-11.
Letting them creep back in it.
Mm-hmm. Starting to look like the last set a little bit. There's a bump by Green to Kroll. There's Renner. She puts it down.
Oh, nice up by Mosley.
Back across by Mosley. There's Bora to Kroll to Renner. Down the line, it's good.
And we got that. Yep.
Good kill that time by Renner. Makes it 16-11. Back in the contest is Bobby Lake for Frontier as Bobcats will be serving. And it's going to be Alyssa Kolak doing the honors. Nice low serve. It's bumped up. There's a set. Kolak to Kroll. There's Renner.
Yep.
That's money. Wow.
When she hits the ball like that.
Woo, not much you can do.
Nope. Especially as small as they are out there blocking her
mm-hmm.
right now.
That was a big hammer shot that time. 17-11.
She's 6 feet and jumps well, and they're 5'5 out there.
Kolak.
That's not fair.
That one's not controlled. But they get it across, and they find the open hole right in front of Sarah Green.
Our middle didn't pull off and pass there.
17-12. Morthland hanging around. Irwin serving. We've had some problems with her serve tonight. That one tips the net. Pedke gets a hold of it, but it's wide. Didn't the rule used to be that if it touched the net at all,
yeah,
it was
no
good?
Yeah, it was a missed serve.
Yeah, okay. So you're not a fan of that.
Well, if it should happen, I think you should be able to block.
Block it, right.
I just don't, like, yeah. You're rewarded for yeah. a serve that hits the net and rolls
yeah.
down. Like, it's just not good volleyball.
No, you don't teach your girls to try to hit the net. I mean, yeah. 18-13. Bobcats with the lead and the serve. Reeves does the honors. Here's a set by Morthland. Across, tip. Renner bumps it up. Now across by Green. A bump, the set. And that's a point for the Patriots. 18-14. Mm-mm.
Lair's had a good game for the Patriots. She works hard there at middle in the front row.
Set number four. In the net. 19-14. Now Renner will serve it. She struggled on her serve last time. Let's see what she does this time. This is a good one. Mosley gets it across to Bora. There's a good spike. And a good point that time as Bobby Lake puts it down hard. And again, a great serve, I mean a great set by Courtney Kroll.
Yeah, when Lake gets the ball right there, it's not much Morthland can do about it.
20-14. Again, it's set number four, just 5 points away from the first ever college volleyball match win by Frontier Bobcats. Can they pull this one out?
I've got a good feeling. Sometimes you got a good feeling.
Mm-hmm.
I think tonight's going to be the night the Bobcats get their first win.
Got a timeout on the floor, and we want to tell you once again that tonight's broadcast is also made possible by Wainwright Propane and Sporting Goods, where they have all their fishing gear at half price. Thinking about doing some fishing, it's all 50% off now at Wainwright Propane in Fairfield. All right, back to live action. Here's a serve by Renner. And that one's misplayed. 21-14. Bobcats starting to smell it now. And they keep it going. Renner from Steelville. It's a good recruit. Nice hard serve. That one's deep. Dug out by Renner. Back across, Sarah Green. Found the hole. Nice.
Sarah's had a really nice night for the Bobcats.
22-14. Renner continuing to serve here. There's a bump, a set, and a spike. That's tip, dug out. Kroll to Green. She gets it across. Dump back across.
Oh.
Whoa!
Nice Renner. Shot by Courtney.
And Green could not quite get it across.
But you love to see that effort.
Oh, yes,
coach.
You do.
I mean,
absolutely.
That ball was on the ground, and Courtney got to it, and then Renner diving after it.
They're letting it all hang out.
They can see that win in their sights here.
22-15. Just 3 points away, but now Morthland will serve it again. And it's Hartline serving for the Patriots. Here it comes. Bora's got it. To Kroll. To Lake. There's a dink across. To Kroll. Across to Green, and she puts it down. Sarah Green put it away. It's 23-15. 2 points away from the first ever collegiate volleyball win for Frontier Community College.
Grace Bora back to serve. We scored a lot of points the last time she served.
Let's see if she can help close it out here. Here's a set.
Nice
block that time. Was it Kroll or was it Kolak?
It was Kroll.
All right, beautiful play. It's set point, match point now for the Frontier Bobcats.
If I had a player of a game to give out, it would be her.
Okay.
Several people played well, but man, she's...
Grace Bora with a serve. There's a set. Dug out. Here's Kroll with a set. Here's Green. She puts it down. That's it. History has been made. As the
Great
Frontier
job,
Bobcats have won their first ever collegiate volleyball match, 3-1. And what a way they did it, too.
Absolutely.
Chet, they lost that first set only to battle back and win the next three in a row as they win this one 25-15. Congratulations, Coach Sarah Hughes and the Bobcats volleyball squad. What a win.
Yes, it was. Coach Hughes has to be extremely happy with their girls. Found a way to win tonight. I think they were the better team. They had more talent, you know, up against a good, you know, a very well-coached team. But really dug in, played well tonight.
Sure did. 25-15, the final on that fourth and final set. Two of the sets went 25-23. You can't get much closer than that. And I'm really glad it didn't go that fifth set because crazy things can happen in that fifth set, particularly when it's shorter. So it's good
and
that the Bobcats could put away. Yeah, it is hot. Time for us to get out of here and go home and cool off a little bit. Huh?
Absolutely.
Chet, appreciate you being on the broadcast again.
Thanks a lot, Randy.
Great job as always,
it.
And best of luck tomorrow night in your volleyball match, and especially good luck this weekend as you're in that tournament up at Casey.
Thank you.
Okay.
Hope we have some good play from our girls.
Yeah, absolutely. Again, the final here, Frontier Community College Bobcats victorious. They win their first ever collegiate volleyball match as they take care of Morthland College tonight, 2-1. Hope that you enjoyed the broadcast. And again, thanks to our sponsors for making it all possible. And this broadcast will also be available in archive tonight as well. So for Chet Snyder, this is Randy Olson saying thanks for listening, thanks for watching. And so long from the Bobcat Den, otherwise known as the Mule Barn at Fairfield Community High School.